Hi everyone, I'm Sajal. I've spent over 10 years as a software engineer and manager at places like Facebook and other top tech companies. On this channel, we dive everything about tech, career, and life. For other interesting topics, don't forget to subscribe the channel. Today, I'll walk you through the career path of a software engineer and highlight the essential skills needed to climb up the ladder. While the different companies might have slight variations in their job titles and expectations, the core structure is pretty similar across the board. To keep things simple, we'll use Google's job-level terminology as an example. We will start at L3, that's where most new college graduates land. From there, it goes to L4, L5, and right up to L10, or maybe even L11 if you're someone exceptional like Jeff Dean at Google. But what do these levels actually represent, besides obviously a bigger paycheck? Let's find out. I think the levels and all the requirements can be best understood by taking an example. So we can use a recent example. Facebook recently launched an app like Threads, which is an Instagram and a Twitter clone, and it has a lot of promises. It needs to have 100 million users and potentially Zuck wants to scale it to 1 billion and so on. So how will this be divided into the organization and what will each level engineer work on? This will be an interesting example to understand how every level engineer operates and what are the problems they are trying to solve. Note that this is just an example, and it's very generic. All senior engineers work very differently. There are even archetypes, which we can talk about in another video. This is a very simple example to just demonstrate the scope of the problems every level of engineer operates at. Let's begin. L9 Plus. At the top of the food chain, we have the level 9 engineers and business strategists. These folks are really looking at a big picture. They're not coding. They're figuring out if there is even a market for Threads. They ask questions like, how many people might use this? Who are our competitors? And is this the right time to launch? Think of them as the captains of the ship, navigating through the stormy weathers of market sizes, competitive analysis, and timing. They need to ensure that investing millions into developing Threads is worth it. They're constantly tuned into the broader tech and social landscape, predicting trends and setting the course. Just a step below, level 8 folks are all about strategy, but more focused on how Threads will operate. Their job might be to link Threads seamlessly with Instagram, making sure that when you hop from Instagram to Threads, it feels like walking into the next room, not a different planet. They also decide the vibe of Threads. Unlike Twitter, for example, which can get pretty heated and negative, Threads aims to be less political. They strategize on algorithms that will uplift more positive and engaging posts. So when you are scrolling, you feel good rather than getting drawn into debate. This is a very strategic and business decision, and that's what L8s Plus do. Level 7 is where we dive into the technicalities. These engineers design the technical roadmap. They're trying to optimize large business goals such as mean time to onboard for a user. This is highly complex, and they convert these kind of metrics into actual technical decisions. Moving to level 6, these engineers get their hands a bit dirty with system design. For example, they might be concerned with how data is connected between Threads and Instagram. This requires system understanding on how user IDs will be stored on both the systems backing Instagram and Threads. They'll figure out the migration plan for these IDs and how these requests will be served from the app. So it's all about creating a system design that can work for the app, not only for today, but also thinking about futuristic problems that might come in 5 years. At level 5, we are looking at component design. Here, engineers are more focused on specific parts of the app. They decide on the backend storage, where your data is kept, and the front-end user flows, how they interact with the app. L5s are usually able to tackle problems on how data is stored securely and efficiently, and how the interface is user-friendly. Down at level 4, and now we really get to the exciting parts. These are engineers who work on the solution design. This might include in designing the UI elements, such as the upload button or the editing interface. It's all about the details here, and it's a lot of fun. L4s focus on these micro-interactions, which might seem small, but have a huge impact on the overall experience of the user on the app. And finally, at L3, we have engineers who implement specific tasks. L3s are the ones who ensure that users can add an image to the post or the thread doesn't exceed the character limit. Every line of code they write is aimed at making Threads a stable, engaging platform. They handle the nuts and bolts that keep the app running smoothly and ensure the experience of the users is bug-free. It's more common than not that every feature has one of the L3s who has touched that codebase. So building an app like Threads isn't just about one person writing a bunch of code. It's a massive team effort, with each level of engineers focusing on different aspects of the app, from big picture business strategies to tiny details of user interaction. Each layer of this engineering hierarchy plays a crucial role. Without the business strategists, the app might not even exist. Without the strategists and technical planners, the app wouldn't have its unique charm. And without the designers and the task implementers, the app wouldn't function at all. It's like building a skyscraper, from laying the foundation to putting on the roof. So understanding what each level means can really help you chart a path in your career, whether you are just starting out or aiming for the top. Let's break down now what engineers need to focus on at each level to grow their careers successfully. Starting at L3, which is often where you land right after graduating from college or a coding bootcamp. As an L3, you are a junior engineer. Your role revolves around implementing tasks with precision and quality. Think of yourself as being responsible for a specific component of a project. At this stage, your work is well-defined and scoped. You are expected to produce clean, well-tested code, handle pull requests, and embrace feedback to learn and improve. The focus here is on consistent productivity. Your senior engineers will guide you, but it's your job to make sure the tasks assigned to you are completed efficiently. Moving up to level 4, you are in the industry for about 1.5 to 5 years. Now you're not just handling features, you're managing entire projects. This is where you start to show independence. You might oversee an L3 working on a component, ensuring that the overall project is well tested and meets the deadlines. At L4, you are still coding, but also reviewing others' work and coordinating with different stakeholders possibly. The shift here is from just coding to leading projects and making sure everything functions as a cohesive unit. Level 5. After a few more years, you might hit L5, where you become a senior software engineer. Here you have a significant impact at the team level. You could be leading the technical direction of multiple projects. This level is all about dealing with ambiguity. You are expected to own problems that don't have clear solutions and you have to figure things out. Your role involves less coding and more strategic work, like integrating systems or improving teams' technical capabilities. You'll be heavily involved in mentoring junior engineers and making decisions that align with the company's objectives. L6. As a staff software engineer at L6, your influence expands across the organization. You're thinking beyond individual projects or teams. You're considering the future of the entire organization. This role requires strong analytical skills to identify key problems and influence others to how to solve them. Your day-to-day might involve less coding and more time spent in strategic meetings, reviewing tech specs, and coaching other engineers. It's all about accountability and ensuring that your team or org hits its objectives effectively. L7. Reaching L7 as a senior staff software engineer, you now impact the company at an executive level. You are involved in high-level technical strategy and help shape the direction across different orgs. Here, strategy is key. You need to plan and think long-term, ensuring sustainable success rather than just short-term gains. In this role, you are likely leading special projects and have considerable freedom to steer initiatives that align with company's goals. Promotion at this level is very challenging and often depends on significant contributions or strategic networking. I'm not an L8+, but this is just my sense by working with other engineers who are L8s and even N9s. So at L8, you are at the pinnacle, like a principal software engineer or a technical fellow. You're not just impacting the company, you are influencing the industry. Your work involves creating new technical areas and innovating at a level where you become a recognized name in the tech community. At this stage, your role is more about vision and less about hands-on coding. You're setting trends and steering the tech community, enjoying the autonomy and recognition that comes with this extensive experience. L9. I don't really have much to say about L9s. I think they are just L8s on steroids. They even have larger influence on the industry and sometimes reshape how the industry would work. Think about ChatGPT. That would be an awesome initiative by an L9 who can think about how LLMs can play a role in human civilization. So wrapping up, each level in software engineering hierarchy has its own set of challenges and focus areas, from mastering coding and project management at the lower levels to strategic thinking and industry leadership at higher levels. It's a journey of continuous learning and adaptation. So whether you are just starting out or eyeing that senior position, understanding these levels can help you focus on the right skills and attitudes you need to advance. I hope this gives you a clear picture of what to expect and how to navigate your career in tech. What did you find the most surprising? Drop your thoughts in comments and let's discuss. Don't forget to subscribe for more insights into the tech industry. Catch you in the next video. See you.